गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। हम लोग स्टार्ट किए हैं चैप्टर एसिड्स बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट्स, जिसमें कि हम लोग एसिड्स का जनरल प्रॉपर्टीज़ के बारे में पढ़ चुके हैं, साथ ही उस क्लासिफिकेशन या टाइप्स ऑफ एसिड्स के बारे में भी हम लोग डिस्कस कर चुके हैं। आज हम लोग बात करेंगे बेस के बारे में, जनरल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ बेसिस। टेस्ट बीटर होगा, सोपी टच का होगा, टर्न्स रेड लिटमस ब्लू, कंडक्ट्स इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इन सॉल्यूशन, सॉल्यूशन मीन्स एक्वस सॉल्यूशन, रिलीजेज ओएच माइनस और हाइड्रोक्सिल आयंस इन एक्वस सॉल्यूशन। तो दीज आर द सम जनरल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ बेसिस। नाउ अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ बेसिस। ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सॉल्युबिलिटी इन वाटर, बेसिस आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू कैटेगरीज। वन इट इज द वाटर सॉल्युबल बेसिस, अनदर इट इज द वाटर इनसॉल्युबल बेस। वाटर सॉल्युबल बेस, द एग्जांपल्स हियर इट इज द सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, बेरियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, पोटासियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, मैग्नीशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, दीज आर द वाटर सोल्यूबल बेसिस। वेर एज कॉपर टू ऑक्साइड, जिंक हाइड्रोक्साइड एटसेट्रा, दीज आर द वाटर इनसोल्यूबल बेसिस। वाटर सोल्यूबल बेसिस आर कॉल्ड एल्कलीज, हियर दीज आर द वाटर सोल्यूबल बेसिस, सो दीज आर कॉल्ड ऑल्सो एल्कलीज, बट दीज आर वाटर इनसोल्यूबल मीन्स दीज आर नॉट एल्कलीज, सिंपली दीज आर द बेसिस। देयरफॉर इट कैन बी सेड दैट ऑल द alkalis are bases but all the bases are not alkalis. From this you can also make the conclusion. Next one, it is the classification on the basis of strength. On the basis of strength, strong base, weak base. In case of a strong base, there is the complete or almost complete dissociation of the base in aqueous solution, whereas in case of weak base, partial dissociation will take place. For example, strong base NaOH, KOH, etc. Whereas the example of weak base, here it is the AlOH, whole 3 aluminium hydroxide, ammonium hydroxide. These are the examples of weak bases. Next one, it is the on the basis of acidity, bases are classified into three categories or three types. One, it is the monoacidic base, second diacidic base, and third one it is the triacidic base. Monoacidic base means the base which on dissociation it gives only one OH minus ion from one molecule, then it is the monoacidic base. Consider this case NaOH. Suppose one molecule of this NaOH it dissociate to give only one OH minus ion, therefore it is the monoacidic base. Now, in case of BaOH hold to barium hydroxide on dissociation, it will produce or give 2 OH minus ion. Therefore, it is the diacidic base. In this triacidic base example, AlOH hold 3, one molecule of OH hold 3 on dissociation, it will give 3 OH minus ion or 3 hydroxyl ion. Therefore, here it is the triacidic base. Our next topic, it is the indicators. Indicators means the substance which indicate. Indicators are the substances which tell us whether a given substance is an acid or a base. Types of indicators. Now, the types of indicators on the basis of occurrence, indicators are of two types. One, it is the natural indicators, and another, it is the synthetic indicators. By term natural indicator means obtained naturally, whereas synthetic indicators means made in laboratories. Examples of natural indicators: litmus, turmeric, vanilla, etc. Whereas examples of synthetic indicators are phenolphthalein, methyl orange, etc. About the litmus, it is obtained from lichen. Original color, it is the purple. Acid turns blue litmus paper into red, whereas base turns red litmus paper into blue. About the turmeric, acid has no effect on the color. Turmeric, it is yellow in color, the color will not change, but base changes yellow color to reddish brown. This yellow color of turmeric, it will change in presence or when this turmeric it comes in contact with the base, it will change to reddish brown. One term or another type of indicator, it is here, it is termed as the olfactory indicators. Olfactory indicators means the substances which change their order with acid and base are called olfactory indicators. एग्जाम्पल वेनिला क्लोव ओनियन एट्सेट्रा. नाउ व्हाट अबाउट वेनिला. इन बेस लूजेज इट्स स्मेल बट इन एसिड द स्मेल रिटेन. Similarly, in case of clove, the smell of clove oil is vanished in base, but in acid, the smell is retained. Now, about the synthetic indicators. One, it is the, we have taken the example, phenolphthalein and another, methyl orange. Generally, these two are generally used in the lab. About the phenolphthalein, colorless solution. Originally, it is colorless, but turns pink with basic solution. And remains colorless in acidic solution. In case of methyl orange, it is orange liquid and turns yellow with basic solution and turns red with acidic solution. Now, whatsoever we have discussed about the indicators, in the tabular form, we can summarize here. Suppose indicator in acidic medium, basic or alkaline medium. Red litmus in acidic medium or acidic solution or in acid, it red litmus, it will remain red. But in basic solution, this red litmus will change to blue color, red to blue. Blue litmus in acidic solution, the color blue color will change to red. But in basic solution, the blue color will retain, no change. In case of phenolphthalein, in acidic solution it is colorless, but in basic or alkaline medium it is pink. Methyl orange in acidic solution or medium it is red, whereas in basic solution or medium it is yellow in color. So these are the some informations regarding the indicators which are generally used in the lab. Now about the chemical properties of acids and bases. First, reaction with metals. What happens when a metal react with an acid? Acid plus metal, then there is the formation of metallic salt and hydrogen gas is liberated. For example, suppose zinc plus hydrochloric acid to give zinc chloride ZnCl2, it is the salt with the evolution of hydrogen gas. Similarly, zinc metal reacts with aqueous solution of H2SO4 to give zinc sulfate and hydrogen. In the same way, metals react with base to give salt and hydrogen gas. For example, zinc react with sodium hydroxide. It is the base. Then it will produce sodium zincate, Na2ZnO2, and hydrogen gas is liberated. Similarly, with aluminium metal, suppose aqueous solution of sodium hydroxide, it is the basic solution, then it will give sodium aluminate NaAlO2 and hydrogen gas is liberated. Next one, reaction with metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates. Metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate plus acid, then salt, carbon dioxide and water are formed. For example, suppose sodium carbonate, it is the metal carbonate. With acid HCl, there is the formation of NaCl, H2O and CO2. Similarly, with metal hydrogen carbonate, NaHCO3, it is the hydrogen carbonate. With HCl, also give NaCl, H2O and CO2. Now, what about the reaction of base with metal carbonates and hydrogen carbonates? Metal carbonates and hydrogen carbonates, these are basic in nature. Therefore, base plus basic nature of these carbonates and hydrogen carbonate, there will be no reaction. One thing is here, the carbon dioxide which is produced, this carbon dioxide has the property to change the color, or it makes or forms the milky appearance when it is passed through lime water. Consider this equation. This is the formula of lime water, COH2, calcium hydroxide. When carbon dioxide is passed, then the lime water, it turns milky. And the milkiness of the lime water, it is due to the formation of solid calcium carbonate. But when excess of carbon dioxide is passed, देन द मिल्कीनेस इट डिसअपियर्स ड्यू टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सॉल्युबल कैल्शियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट. कंसिडर दिस इक्वेशन, कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट प्लस H2O एंड CO2, एक्सेस ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इफ इट इज पास्ट, देन देयर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सॉल्युबल कैल्शियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट्स एंड दैट्स वाई द मिल्कीनेस इट डिसअपियर्स. नेक्स्ट वन, रिएक्शन बिटवीन एन एसिड एंड अ बेस. जनरल रिएक्शन, एसिड प्लस बेस टू गिव सॉल्ट एंड वाटर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, HCl प्लस NaOH टू गिव NaCl प्लस H2O. सिमिलरली H2SO4 प्लस अगेन NaOH, देन इट गिव सोडियम सल्फेट एंड वाटर. नेक्स्ट वन, इट इज द रिएक्शन विथ मेटल ऑक्साइड्स. मेटल ऑक्साइड प्लस एसिड, देन देर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सॉल्ट एंड वाटर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड, इट इज द मेटल ऑक्साइड, एसिड HCl, then there is the formation of CaCl2, it is the salt and H2O water. Similarly, copper 2 oxide plus HCl, there is the formation of copper 2 chloride and water. In the same way, base plus non-metal oxide, the reaction between these two also gives salt and water. Consider this equation. Suppose it is the non-metal oxide CO2, carbon dioxide non-metallic oxide, and CaOH hold 2, it is the base. The reaction between these two, then there is the formation of calcium carbonate plus H2O. Similarly, when carbon dioxide is passed through that NaOH aqueous solution, then there is the formation of sodium carbonate and water. So these are the some chemical properties of the acids and bases. Okay, thank you.